to be moved. Then you can point forward and say, I've been in college, I finished it. If I got a desire to be a doctor, I'm going to be a doctor. They say, how you know you're going to be that? Because Jesus on the inside of me.
Destroyed marriage, it has lost its image.
Yeah.
Amen.
Amen.
Satan has gave marriage another ideal beside God's ideal. Therefore, you wrestling through your flesh trying to fix what God has gave an image. If your marriage not reflecting the image of God, how many know every image have to have a shadow to put forth an image? If your marriage not reflecting the image of God, you'll never fix it outside of God. And that's why we always have marriage made better, because nothing made us better except the word of God. Amen. Before I go forward, amen, I want to announce that December the 15th will be co-pastor and I anniversary. Yeah. Come on up here. Let me model this girl. Yeah. Go ahead and pop. Thank you. That's from not putting strain on her. You heard me. That's for not making her do something outside God's will.
Yes, that's good right there.
That's from not letting her struggle. I gave her life for her to keep living. And she gave me life so I can keep living. So marriage is not based on how you fix it in your natural. It's how you get back to the image of God. Praise the Lord. Yeah, buddy. 45 years and we still got a smile. 45 years, you can drive up in our house and we ain't got to come down before you come in. You won't hear us in the parking lot. Our neighbor next to us told me one morning, she just out of the blue, it just really... I hear God's voice talk to me. She began to tell me and thank me. She say, I thank you for being such a faithful people of God. And then she said, I thank you for being my neighbor. So something about us impresses her that we are who we say we are.
Amen.
Amen. And we are role models of some people because of our marriage in God.
Amen.
Praise God. And I thank God for the people that are chasing not after us, but chasing after the God that has set our marriage as an example to others. Praise the Lord God Almighty. It's amazing how she has gathered herself together, amen, to agree with me about some things that we mean her both need. And one of them was to work out. That's one of the things I pray that I want my wife to do because she's no good, unhealthy. There's no need, amen, that you're not being able to enjoy our great grapes.
Amen.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Lord. And there's no need to be unhealthy trying to live in the blessing of things and you're unhealthy.
Come on.
I told her she get that body right. When she get that money right, all of it will be together.
Amen.
Praise God. And she agreed to work out. And she agreed to go on a weight loss. And she haven't quit yet. Praise the Lord. And we're not fighting each other over what we don't eat and ain't gonna eat. Don't
Jesus. Amen.
But it's terrible when you see the stuff coming on back on you don't want to have on you. It make you quit and get it right. I just thank God for my wife being a push in my life.
Yeah.
Amen, yeah. You ever thought about being incomplete? Amen. I feel like I'm not complete when my wife is not around helping me on my right side. Because she sees things about me I don't see. And she almost know me better than I know me. You know they do. You can argue like you didn't, or you don't know. They know exactly. You just be arguing all of a sudden. You get what she said that you like. You say, oh, anyway. Yeah, anyway. But I thank God, and you got to understand, God put her there for that reason. She is your helpmate. Amen. Not your hellmate. She's there to help you do what you can't do. She's there to help you see what you think you see, but you really don't see, man.
Come on.
No matter how good you are, but I'm a man. I'm no man to do that high. I could do. Yeah. Then you point that scripture out to him. Yeah. If you let your wife play the role, do the role that God has set her in, your marriage will go much better. She is your wisdom. Because he called her. Wisdom is calling her. Hello, somebody. And I have to admit, she is my wisdom. She know how quick I am to just jump and go. I get my mind set, I'm just like, and I need a bell ring. To make me stop in Salah. I'm like a Peter. If you tell me to do something, I'm running with it. But I thank God for my wife that has allowed me to be the man of God I'm supposed to be.
Amen.
And the husband that God called me to be.
Amen.
Amen. And the grandfather and the father that God called me to be. It makes it so easy for me to be because of her. And now going on 45 years, amen, there was a time we remember that we had some rough roads to travel on, amen, through life. It ain't always been this way, so don't get caught up in your mind like it has. Man, 20-something years of that was a battle. Amen. 20-something years of that was tough, rough, hellacious, because it was without God. Soon as I find God, I forgot about talking about what I used to do. Yeah. Start talking about what I'm going to be.
Amen. Amen.
Amen. Nothing has made us who we are except God Himself. Amen. Clap your hands for the Lord. I just appreciate my wife. We got so many things we're going to do together. We got so many things left on this earth that we're going to do together. Amen. To Jesus come, because God called us together. Not only that, we went to jail together. But we're going to do better. We're doing better. And we're going to bring a lot. I married quite a few people this year. It started out like that. Y'all have it rough. It's okay. It's gonna soon smooth out. It's going to come together sooner or later. Amen. Just stay up under the word of God. You'll see that thing smooth out. Amen. I want to say tonight before I hand it over to my wife to preach, first lady of the church, co-pastor Lawrence. Yeah. We're soon going to have a pretty little container, not a little, a big one, container out here. Because every year we have it out that say, given to Jesus.
Amen.
Yeah. And when we have this container out, we usually take a family, chosen family, that's having struggles real hard about celebrating Christmas. And we really, you know, we put stuff, we put food, you can bring everything, put it in there. But we also choose a family that needs some help and having to put their name on the paper and a list of things they want Jesus to bring, not Santa Claus. And us, the church, amen, this is the time and season of giving. Us, the church, begin to give to help the family. Men, know God bless you. What you make happen for others, God will make happen for you, amen. So, Sister Sarah, Sister Shayla, Pastor Sister Shayla, going to have that pretty, nice, glittering box to give Jesus a gift. Out here soon, and we're going to put a family name and list out there on the table that you'll be able to, don't act like you got old-timer disease and walk by. Stop by and look at the names, and then they not out there right now, but we're going to have it up. Yeah, we got the family. Yeah, it's Brother Cleveland and Sister Cleveland family. Yeah. We're going to help them. Now, I told baby girl, where she at? I told her, I said, don't go. Yeah, what you put on that? She put, I didn't put nothing too expensive on. I said, well, you should have put what you really wanted on there. At least I would have put it on now.
Yeah, put two or three of them on there.
Yeah, I'll put it on now because God can move. Amen. If they're going to give me something, they might as well give me the best. Don't come up here with a garage sale or something and throw at me. Don't go get some already used stuff and throw at me. Come on now. Listen, when you give, you're going to be given in perspective that you're going to get the same thing back. So I hope you don't come give up some rusty stuff because that's what you're going to get back. So we're going to be focused on making the Cleveland family very happy. Amen. Praise God. Amen. I love it, man. See a sad face turn into a smiling face.
Amen.
Just dance a little bit. I love it, man. I'm amazed at what God is doing at this church and how God changing people's life, change other people's life. And this morning was an amazing thing to see my brother-in-law and sister-in-law and also my sister and her family coming to to the church.
Amen.
It's not just your church. And you know, it's amazing how God is changing people's life. Some people ain't never taste what you taste. We forget about how I was started off. Amen. But they coming in getting the same experience that you done forgot about. Amen. God going to consistently bless your life, honey. And your kids. Just keep on coming. Just keep on letting God have his way. Oh, it's wonderful to have you part of the family of God. Brother Cleveland, I remember you came in, amen, visiting you and your sons. I tell you, this is a powerful man of God. Now, I'm going to tell you something. You can't be wrestling with the world and be that powerful. Very anointed man of God. He got some CDs him and Kim made together. I mean, no, this one song he sang about the fire. Sookie. It come all over me. That's because you're anointed to do something. He's one of my students in the School of Prophet, too. I always told you you're a great man of God, and that's the power of it, you becoming more of a man of God. Through the tribulation and trial that you face, you still let God work on you. That's part of becoming a man of God. Amen. God wrestles with some stuff that's defected in us. Amen. We allow him to work it out. And we become better. Amen. We get more on our way than what we start with. So I thank God for you and your sons. Amen. As y'all continue, and Sister LaManna and her kids as well. I told y'all a blended family. Y'all going to come together and be one. If God is one, you're going to be one too. God bless you. All right, let's put our hands together. Just want you to announce that. Beware of that. Bless them. Let's bless them until they faint. Let's make them feel good about being blessed. Let's make them feel good about being a part of a family that really care. Can you say amen? Well, let's all stand and give a welcome to the First Lady of Dominion, co-pastor Shirley Lawrence. Yes, as she come and preach the gospel of Jesus Christ. Yes.
Praise the Lord. Come on and give God a clap praise for our pastor. Praise the Lord. What a great man of God he is. Amen. A powerful man of God. Amen. And I know because I stay with him all the time. Amen, and he's always doing what he does, amen. He does it, and he does it well, and he loves doing it, amen. And I thank the Lord for saving him, amen, saving me, and keeping us together all of these years, amen. You know, he said 20-something years. We were together like 14 years when we got saved because Ken was in touch still. Yeah, amen.
And 20 of you are still here.
And that's something, you know, before, and I'm going to let you sit down. Don't take me picking my nose. No, but I'm just kidding. Praise God. Glad you cut it out. But, you know, that's the thing. The one thing that I really and true, Pastor and I both really strive to stress toward you, newlywed people and those that are thinking about getting married and those that have been married for a minute, that it's, every day is not peachy keen. No, y'all don't say that. Y'all know every day is not peachy keen. No matter how much you love your spouse, if they get on your nerves. Now, you'd be lying in the front of God right now if you didn't say, oh, Lord, the very same thing that I thought was so darn cute is driving me insane. Come on now. You can turn that off, Brother Kendall, for me if you want to. Praise the Lord. Let's bless the Lord tonight. Amen. Glory to God. Let's do our confession and then you can be seated. This is my Bible.
I am what it says I am.
I can do what it says I can do. I am a believer and not a doubter. I am a doer, not just a hearer. And my life is the better after having heard the word of faith. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. Lord, we thank you for this opportunity. Have your way in this house. In Jesus' most awesome name, amen. You may be seated this evening. Amen.
I
did want to say about Sister Jerrica, amen, as long as she's in y'all house, she gonna tell it on y'all? Yeah, as long as she's in y'all house, she gonna tell it on y'all. She gonna pray for y'all. And y'all are never gonna go in like, because she is truthful. That is one thing that I have found out about Sister Jerrica, is that she doesn't lie. She's never lied to me, you know, and she's upfront. And if she does something, she owns up to it, you know. And I remember, I think I was testifying about Sister Lamanda was swinging at her head so hard. Sister Lamanda was crying and swinging. I don't know where you were, Sister Mary. I don't know if you was here yet or what. But me and Pastor drove up next to her. Pastor said, hey. She said, you just don't understand, Pastor. She come up out of that car like a wild woman. She said, get up. Sister Lamanda needed some help, and just Jerrica got out that car. She was like, "Wow, you know, I saw Jerrica." But you know what? God has blessed you. I know that y'all relationship has come a long, long ways from that. And you know, and I can tell you something else. I remember the days that Sister Lamanda cried for her babies. They cried and cried and cried for her daughter and her son, and she wanted her kids. And God blessed you. You see how God blessed you? Amen. Not only that, I remember Sister Lamanda walked to church. She became a member of Dominion all by herself. There was some other people with her, but she walked to church. And I remember when her and her other husband was together, and Sister Lamanda wanted a baby. You remember that, Sister Lamanda? Little Sister Lamanda said, "Of course I do." Amen. And it just didn't seem like it was going to happen, did it? And then all of a sudden, bam, there it was. And there she is walking around here somewhere. Amen. Amen. But you know what? God has answered a lot of your prayers, hasn't he? You got your mother sitting back there with you. Amen. You got your husband sitting beside you. You got your kids back there. And what I was going to say, too, is, you know, don't be weary in having a blended family. Ask Sister T and Pastor Ken. Amen. It was hard at first, wasn't it? Sister T always, and Sister T has always been a very, very strong person. When she got saved, God saved her strong. Amen. And I really and truly believe she was a strong woman in the world. Amen. To put up with what she put up with. But I would see Sister T's face downcast many a day. And I'd say, what's wrong? You know, what's wrong? And she just couldn't get a hold of it good. Because there's not that much of a difference in the age of her and her children. Amen. When they came into her life, amen, because I think Deja was 9 when y'all moved over here, amen, or when you and Pastor Ken started dating, she was 9, and Kara was maybe what, 11, and Kendrick was like 13 or 14 years old, and she was in her 20s, you were in your, so there wasn't a great bunch of age difference there. And so, and she'd never been a mom to 3 kids, and you just barely had Deja come to live with you, right? How long had Deja lived with you? And so it was a big difference, and there was a struggle, and the struggle was not with her and Pastor Ken. The struggle was with the kids. The kids were struggling with one another. And, you know, everybody, I don't know what they needed. I don't know what they wanted. I don't even know if they knew what they wanted, amen? But you know what? With God, it all came together. It all came together. It worked out for the good, didn't it? And y'all became a great family, and you become even more of a great family. So today, you know, I'm telling you, if you're in a blended family situation, hold on and let God. Turn around, look at your neighbor and say, hold on and let God. Amen. God, I'm telling you, God has got something in store for you because there is purpose. Amen. We're going to talk about tonight. Amen. I'm trying to find the sentence that I wrote so that we can have it for our subject title today. Amen. But there is purpose. Okay. God has purpose for our marriages. And that's what I said, our marriages. Amen. Purpose for our marriages. And for the young people, the teenagers, and the unmarried people in here, God has purpose for every relationship that you get in.
I'm not talking about boyfriend-girlfriend relationships. I ain't talking about that. But even in that, you know, how many know there's absolutely nothing wrong with dating? There is absolutely nothing wrong with dating. And, you know, and the parents are going, don't be telling my kids there ain't nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with dating when the age is appropriate. I said there is nothing wrong with dating when the age is appropriate. How in the world is anybody going to ever get married if they don't date? Come on now. And in my sin, you need to date more than one person. Not at the same time. But you need to date more than one person. Sometimes, a lot of times, people will get into relationships. The first person that they dated, that's their life mate. Did you hear what I say? Life mate. That's your life mate. But, you know, that's far and in between. And you need to date people. You need to have a relationship with other people. You need to get to know other people. And that's not only for the teenagers. And the parents, you decide when's the perfect age for your kids to start dating. They don't decide when it's time for them to start dating. You decide when it's time for them to start dating. Okay? Check it out. All right? We were very stern and with Kara and Deja as far as makeup and all of that kind of stuff. They didn't need makeup. They're beautiful. They didn't need any makeup. We started off, we said you can have some lip gloss. It can be clear or it can be pink, but that's as much as you can have. You can have your nails done and you can paint your toes, but that's as far as it's going. Amen. Now, we'll do your hair. We'll cut it. We'll color it. Help us, Jesus. Amen. And they went from all kinds of colors in their head. I don't know what it was. Kara had pink one time, blue, I don't know, purple. I'm going like, oh, my God, I'd be so glad. Now she's wrestling with hair growth now. But, you know, and you know, and I'm going like, Lord, I'd be so glad when they run through these trends. You know, the long hair person want to cut it off. The short hair person want to put some extensions in. Amen. I'm going like, boy, I'll be glad when y'all get satisfied. And then they wanted to wear makeup. And we're going like, when you turn 16 years old, you can wear as much makeup as you want to every day. And so me and Sister T were telling them, when you get ready to wear makeup, you're not going to wear makeup every day. It's going to get old. We get tired of getting up putting this stuff on every day. That's why I be looking at half the women in Dominion going, girl, where your lips at? Where's your makeup? Now, you did not look in the mirror and come out looking like that. No, you didn't. No, you didn't. No, you didn't. If you did, don't do it again. That natural aspect of things just don't work.
No, it don't.
It does not work. It don't. Find you a 5-minute routine and get it down pat. Slay that thing. But make sure you put something on.
Amen.
I asked Sister T yesterday, I said, is everything okay? She said, why is my makeup running? Is it not there? You can't see it? I was going like, you okay? I was just thinking something was wrong. Amen. But I thank the Lord. I mean, you make up in your mind. Thanks to God, don't grow your kids up too fast. Don't grow your kids up too fast. Don't grow them up too fast. And as these kids have grown up, amen, I'm watching them, Kara and Deja, now they want to revert. Didn't you? You talk about, oh, no, not the world. I'm staying at it, Papa. No, ain't no papa now. Get your tail on out there. Now, you for real now. You ain't even a teenager no more. Get on out there. So we tell all the time, you better pass because you're not coming back to live with us. Glory to God. No, I don't care what you tell your kids. Your kids are quivers in your, arrows in your quiver, and you're supposed to shoot those babies out. Boom, send them out there. So therefore, we need to get together as mother and father and get together on the same type of adult parenting skills and make sure that your kids never put one against the other.
Amen.
Don't do that. Get on the same page. Keep it right. Keep it stern. Amen. Keep it loving. Keep it forgiving. But let them know this is what's going to happen. It's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. It's not happening. 16, you know, a lot of people think 16 is old enough to date. If that's what you feel like, do for it. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. We ain't have any that dated at 16, so we don't have to go there. So, but anyway, y'all do what y'all want to do. It's for the better to be a very stern, strict parent. I grew up in a very stern, strict home, and it did not hurt me none whatsoever. Amen. Now, let's get into our lesson tonight. I was talking about this morning, amen, that, you know, because men are so positional, amen, that they want what they want because they feel like, amen, their position justifies them behaving the way that they do. Because you're a man. I said so. That don't make a bit of difference. Now, you're going to have to give me a little bit more than because I said so. And we can't do that to our kids either because I said so. We need a reason for it. Amen. I'm willing to go along with you as long as you can tell me and I can see why this is going to be for the best of both of us. Not because I said so. Amen. Most people get married for selfish reasons. Can anybody agree with me on that one? People get married for selfish reasons. Amen. Thinking that it'll fill a void in your life. It's not going to fill the void in your life. The void has to be filled by God. Amen. I said the void has to be filled by God. Amen. Amen. Thinking it will fill a void in your life. It'll give you security. It'll give you the sexual pleasure that you're looking for. Amen. Come on now. Glory to God. And one of the main reasons, and this is one of the main reasons for divorce, because all of the things that you thought about you were getting into your marriage for, you get into your marriage and you find out the need is not being met. I don't feel secure in this marriage. Why? Because you don't work. And when you work, you ain't bringing in enough money. And when we get money, you spend it. You don't take care. Our priorities are wrong. Come on now. We're not on the same priority page. Let's get on the same priority page. While we talking, you know, lovey, lovey, googie, googie, let's start making some lists out. Where you see yourself in the next 2 years? What do you see yourself doing in the next 5 years? I want to know what I'm getting myself into. Because if you don't even have a vision and you don't even have a goal, we're going to put this thing off for a little while longer. Even us in our marriage right now, we need to sit down and talk about our future. Pastor and I are always talking about our future. We're talking about the future that God has in store for us, and everything in the future includes dominion. Amen. Because this is our life. This is what God has called us to do. This is our mandate. But how many know that God does not mind us having lively pleasures in life while we're serving the kingdom? See, a lot of people get mixed up. They feel like that if you get committed, if you get sold out into the kingdom of God, if you get completely committed into the kingdom of God, life vanishes. That's not the truth. It is not the truth. What it is life intensifies. Because you know what? The favor of God is on you because you're obedient to the kingdom word. God blesses the people that are obedient to his word. He'll even cause men to give into your bosom. I heard Pastor Michael said that they took their 5-day, 10-day. How long were y'all gone? Long time. Don't do it no more. Y'all go, we missed the kids. Woo, where the little girls at? Amen. But they took that trip 9 or 10 days out to San Diego and didn't have to pay a dime. Come on now. Didn't have to pay a dime. I'm not telling their business. He stood up and testified about it on Tuesday. How many know the fly to San Diego cost some dollars? Uh-huh. It costs dollars. Even if you book it way in advance, it still costs dollars. And it's four of them. And they did all this crazy stuff. Crazy stuff. Did I mention that you cannot plan a vacation I'm going on? No, you can't. Don't take me out into no desert talking about dune riding. Talk about dune buggy ride. I'm going like, I got your dune buggy. If I catch you, you are in trouble, girl. You are in trouble. Amen. The only thing I want to see is some sand with a cabana. was a water out there, amen? Praise the Lord. But that is one of the main reasons for divorce is because we get married for the wrong reasons. You know, sometimes we get married because we got children coming. I personally do not think that is a reason to get married. That is not a reason. Okay, I got two clap praises, but it don't make me no difference because it's not the word of God. It is my opinion. So you can clap if you want to and not if you don't want to, but that's my opinion. I don't think that that's a reason to get married. I think that's a reason to have the baby, and I think that's a reason for each parent to support the child, but I don't think that's a reason to get married. Because if that person can't support you in that baby, there ain't no sense of y'all talking about getting married. Where you going to live with me? No. No, you not. You're not coming up in him. No, 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 no. Oh, no. Oh, no, you ain't. Amen. Or you're unhappy oftentimes. You're unhappy. Oftentimes it's an abusive relationship. And it's from lack of knowing why you got married. Why did you get married? What was your reasoning for getting married? What did you think the purpose of getting married was going to be? Sex? No matter how good it is and how often it happens, gets old. It's got to be more to your relationship than sex. There has to be more to your relationship than sex. Amen. Praise the Lord. No matter how good it is, you got to get up sometime. It's just not physically sensible to have sex 24 hours a day. It's I don't know. I don't think you're capable. I just strengthened my stomach muscles. That hurt. She said, go into a coma. You going to go into a something? Amen. Glory to God. Amen. Amen. Oh, why do you want a relationship or a friendship, amen, for the single people and the teens? Why do you yearn for that friendship? Why is that friendship, especially in girls? Girls feel like they just have to have Dooley Frass as their friend girl. They have to be in that group. They have to have that friendship. Why do you have to have that friendship? And when you are the one that's wanting the friendship the most, it's usually you getting abused in the relationship. Lead your own group. Be in your own group. Come on. It's the same thing with us grown people. You know, I don't have to be your friend. I simply don't have to be your friend. You don't have to be my friend. We can be cordial toward one another. Hey, how you doing? And, you know, we could even go get a Coke sometimes. But that doesn't mean that we have to have this solid relationship. Saints of God, don't you understand that marriages are ordained by God? I love what Pastor was saying because it was right on in this message. Jesus Christ, amen, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit are one. And so as they are one, so are we as married people. We're one. Amen. Glory to God. Come on. So you can be by yourself and still have a good time. You can be by yourself and still have a good time. Now listen, God made us, I don't know what the word is, communicable. He made us with the spirit of community in us. We do need relationships. God created us like that. Amen? Why? one of our first scriptures that I'm going to get in my head of myself, but I'm going to do it anyway. Amen. Where it said Genesis, amen, where it said it was God seen everything that he did and it was good. And then he looked at the man over there all by himself. Adam over there just twiddling his fingers around. He was looking at the lion and the lioness and going, I say. Then he come over here and, you know, and he look at the cheetahs. Amen. You know, Adam did not name the cheetah monkey. He needed us to name the cheetah monkey. Amen. And you know, he looked at all these things, and Adam is just going like, well, they're having fun. And they're having fun. And so God said, you know, it's not good for Adam to be alone. So what did he do? He created a mate for Adam. So marriage, amen, and community was created by God. He wants us to have, remember, we're talking about purpose in your marriage, amen. Praise God. And you know, we were looking for companionship. We were looking for children. And we were looking for happiness. Amen. All of this stuff was associated with marriage. Oh, we love that person so. We like them so much. You know what? You like them so much. You love them so much. Well, what are y'all going to be doing in the next 5 years? Did you sit down before you got married and say anything 20 years from now? What do you think we're going to be doing? Think about it right now, all of us married couples. Where are you going to be next year? Where are you going to be 2 years from now? Where are you going to be 5 years from now? How many want to go see Jesus this year? Nobody. Amen, nobody. How many want to go see Jesus in 20 years? Nobody. 40? Do I hear 50 in the house? Amen, come on now. Amen. Amen. Me either. Me either. You know, and I'd be past my 120 mark by then. Amen. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. You know, so if you're contemplating getting married, if you just now got married, amen, or if you're thinking about getting married in the future, think about what is your purpose for getting married. We're going to answer some of that in just a minute. How many of us look to God for the definition of marriage? Do any of us now, even being married, do we look at a definition that God has for marriage? Does our marriage stand up to God's definition of marriage? Amen. Amen. So, what is God's purpose for marriage? And let me tell you this. Let's take a sidestep. The perfect marriage was lost because of Adam. I said that this morning. Y'all said, well, it's Eve's fault. No, it was Adam's fault. If you want to throw out some blame, it was Adam's fault. Why? Because he was that person that y'all always argue about and say, look at me, look at me. Look at me. I'm the man. I'm the man. Adam was the man. He should have and I've said this. I made a lot of ladies mad at me. He should have told Eve, you better go sit down. What is wrong with you? He say, I was told when you were told, but I was told before you were told. I was in a relationship with God before you even existed. God has always been good to me. He's never let me go in lacking anything. And Adam chose his wife over God.
Where are the brothers at? Where are the brothers at?
You know, if nothing irks me more, and I'm just here to be truthful. If you know anything about Co-Pastor Cheryl, you know I'm going to tell you the truth, whether you like it or whether you don't like it, whether you think it's harsh, crude, or rude. One thing that really get on my nerve is a man that puts so much emphasis on his wife. You say, wait a minute, Pastor just showed you off. Yeah, he showed me off. But I guarantee you, how many of y'all have been sitting in this hymn, very church, this hymn, very congregation, when pastor get up and say, Cheryl, I hope you don't mind, but let me correct you on that one. How many of y'all been sitting here when it felt like, you know, she ought to melt. She ought to melt. Give me a clap praise. I didn't melt. Let me tell you why I didn't melt. It's because, number one, it's all for my good. Number two, I'm thick-skinned, so I don't get offended as easily, or my feelings don't get hurt as easily as some of y'all would share, think, act like your feelings get so hurt. If there's not anything, it really get on my nerve is a man that puts so much emphasis on his wife that he'll do stupid stuff because of his wife is a woman that acts wimpy all the time. That ain't cute. It does not. God created both of us to be strong enough to persevere, Hallelujah. To be bountiful, to be fruitful. Yeah. Amen. To be courageous and to get out and conquer. Amen. I mean, you might be a little bit more sensitive. Amen. That's all right. Amen. I'm sensitive too. Amen. But the perfect marriage was lost because of Adam. That's not my opinion. That's the word. Adam was not deceived. Adam knew better. And he didn't tell Eve to go sit down. Okay, baby, whatever you want. Whatever. And lost the best house in the best neighborhood that you could ever have. Women in this house, you don't want to marry a man that can't stand his ground. Oh, yeah, you better come on. You don't want to marry a man that can't stand his ground. You don't want to marry somebody that's going to keep you outside all the time, keep you without all the time. You don't ever get nothing good because he can't control the household. All the men in the house going like, really, is this a man bashing? No, I'm talking about marriage and how God purposed it. You want to be a man, be a man. Just because you father some kids don't make you a man. Because you have the equipment that God created men with don't make you a man. To stand up under God's order and in his purpose is what makes you a man. Let me move on because I know Brother Eddie is itching to stand up with that sign. He want to put this to an end. Amen. It ain't ending, Brother Eddie. It is not ending. Brother Eddie talking about how she figure me out. I feel your spirit. Yeah, talk about we going to cut her down, man, Brother Will, up that time. About, don't do it. Don't do it. Tell me, no, man, she mean. Don't do that. His sister was wrestling with him the other night. I say, what you doing, Sister Shawnice? He say, oh, no, she over here being abusive and stuff. It was funny because she was just all over. I say, y'all done went back to 15, haven't you? Amen. Glory to God. Let's look at Genesis 1:26. Amen. Because this is what God gave us to do. I said, gave us. Genesis. Amen. 1. Praise the Lord. And the 26th verse. If you've read this once here in this house, you've read it 100 times. Amen. And it says, from the American Standard, said, and God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, and over the birds of the heavens, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. And God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him, male and female, he created them. And God blessed who? Who? Him. Yeah, he blessed them. And he said unto who? Who did he say it to? Be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth and subdue it and have dominion. Who did he tell to have dominion? Who? He didn't tell him, did he? And he didn't tell her, did he? He said he told them to have dominion. Amen? Turn around and look at your mate and say, honey, I'm necessary. Amen. He said, have dominion over the fish of the sea and over the birds of the heavens and over every living thing that moveth about the earth. Amen. Glory to God. And so God gave us dominion and he gave us position. Amen. Praise God. Marriage has always been God's idea. We are created in the image of God. And for anything to be successful and fruitful, it must be in the image of God. Anything in your marriage has to be in the image of God. If it's not in the image of God, you need to start saying Adam and Eve. Saints of God, we need to sit down and discuss every decision. Amen. So in our marriage, we should see the reflection of two becoming one. As God the Father, God the Son, and God the Spirit, that's God the Spirit is. Amen. Glory to God. Here's the reason why Satan is so intent on keeping division and chaos in the marriage. We got people in here right now that have husbands and have wives that are not in the house with them tonight. That's a divided house. You know what? I'm one of them preachers that don't care whether you say amen. Amen. I'm not going to even ask you to. Amen. Because it's the truth. And so Satan is intent on keeping division and chaos in the marriage. So intent on destroying marriages. Every time he sees marriage, listen at this, saints of God. I want you to hear it very well. Every time Satan sees marriage where two people truly have become one, the devil sees a reflection of God's nature. Now, here, yeah, come on now. Now, let me show you this. Here are the key words right now. Two people, amen, truly, two people that have truly become one. Two people that have truly become one. Pastor and I are truly one. This is until Jesus takes us home or Jesus breaks the clouds of glory and gets back here on this earth. We're together. Amen. And we're going to talk it out, Brother Jeremy. We're going to talk it out. Are we going to make a decision, Sister Sarah? We're not going to talk about that right now. Let's just wait. Let's bring it down. I mean, because both of us are very high voltage people. And it can get pretty loud if we let it. But I know for a fact that when you acting like that, God ain't in that. God is not in it. I'm not going there. And I'm not going to be smart alecky and pop off and all of that kind of stuff. I'm just going to say, I'm not going there. That's not God. I am not going there. And I mean it. I'm not going there. I refuse to let the devil in on my relationship. Amen. Pastor said the other night when we were talking, I don't know if it was in Bible study, if it was in Sunday service, and he said, sin is of the devil. Y'all remember that? We were reading those scriptures and it said, sin is of the devil. And he said, I hate the devil and I refuse to indulge in anything that gives him glory. I refuse to indulge in anything in my relationship that will give glory to the devil. Amen. Amen. People rarely go into marriage thinking about it being a reflection of God's image. Amen. Any agreeers in here? Is that what you thought about when you got married? Or is that what you're thinking about now in case you're thinking about getting married? Oh, wow. This union is really going to reflect the love of God. Huh? Somebody going to ask me. This is the scenario here. Somebody going to ask me, how do you and your wife get along so well? Why do you and your husband get along so well? And what is going to be your answer when somebody asks you that? Girl, we just had a whole bunch of counseling. Oh, I just love Bae, you know, and me and Bae get along, so he's my best friend. She's my best friend. Oh, you know, that's another pet peeve of mine. Best friend. I mean, seriously. That's the best thing you can say about your spouse. They my best friend. It's because they listen to you and agree with all of your stupidity. They your best friend. Because you ain't got nobody else to go tell that garbage to. They my best friend.
And they out there going, but they are.
Jesus should be your best friend. Hallelujah. Jesus should be your best friend.
Because when you tell your wife something that she don't want to hear, let's see what happened. Best friend and turned into a tarantula. Come on. Go tell your husband best friend something that you done. Amen. Like maybe went over $200 on the credit card. Let's see what kind of a best friend he going to be to you. All right. Best friend. You better get on your knees and start praying to God. Jesus, please show me where to get $200 so that he won't be mad at me, because you know he going to be mad at you, best friend. Amen. Women go into marriages thinking, oh, well, he going to support me. Some women do. Some women are so desperate, they go like, I don't care if he don't do nothing but play games all day as long as he cute. As long as he cute. As long as I think he cute. Because I seen some people that married some folks that they thought was cute, and I was going like, that y'all need glasses. What is wrong with you? But you know, I'm the one that knows that it ain't all in looks. So you know what? It's not all in looks. Amen. It ain't all in looks. It's all in the ordination of the Lord. Amen. You better take the man that God sent you. You better take the woman that God sent you. Instead of talking about, I'm going to wait for, what did Pastor say? 36, 24, 36. Amen. Women looking for 6'2". Amen. Broad shoulders. What do you call that? Flat stomach. What they call that? Six pack. 12. Whatever pack. Amen. They looking for all that. You go like, really? You want all of that. You want this man 6'2", well built, well fixed up, and you 4'4", and you weigh 375. All right, okay. 3 liter. No setups tomorrow. Sister Ginger didn't help me out. Amen. And then the man is looking for a woman that's going to provide his needs. Amen. She's going to cook for him. She's going to clean up for him. She's going to wash his clothes and do all this kind of stuff. Amen. So that's the majority of the reasons why people get married. Of course, you know, we get married for companionship. Amen. But we never ever get together thinking we will reflect God's image. But the word of God told us that we're created in the image of God. See, he over there with the 5-minute sign. That's all right. Amen. He talking about, I read her notes. I know what she going to say next. I'm going to throw this 5-minute sign up on her. That's all right. Amen. But we never think about getting together because we're going to reflect God's image. Amen. But this is the ultimate purpose of our marriage. Remember I told you that we were going to talk about what your purpose of marriage is? The ultimate purpose of our marriage is to reflect Christ. And I'm going to say it again, and I don't care. This is something for you to ponder. And this is something for you to go home and decide with your spouse that ain't here with you. Do you really love God? Uh-huh. Do you really love God? Well, why is it on a night like tonight you would choose to stay at home? Uh-huh. Uh-huh. No, I am not picking at you. You are not that important for me to pick at. It's a whole bunch of people in this house tonight that need to know that our marriages are to reflect the image of Christ. Pastor, and my marriage reflects the image of Christ. It didn't always reflect the image of Christ, but it does now. And I am here to tell you, after 40-something years and a lot of years of hell, like some of y'all are still going through, y'all look cute on the outside the house, but once you get on the inside, you do have to go to the back room to argue just in case somebody comes and knocks on the door. All right? Glory together. Glory together. Glory to God. We cannot cast aside what God intends for us. Not being a true believer of Jesus Christ, we cannot cast aside what God intends for our marriages. This morning I said, if you're in an abusive relationship, get out. I'm telling you today, if you're not in a relationship that, amen, that shows the image of God, don't get married in that. Don't get married in that. There's a lot of people in this world. And there is other people besides the one that you with that is not going to reflect the image of Christ with you. If they're not going to be in the house of God with you, if they're not going to love God like you love God, this is what I'm saying. Women, don't get a man that don't love God, that love you more than they love God. You may as well turn your name to Eve. Adam loved Eve more than he loved God and God's word. After God had created him and gave him everything and even gave him Eve, he turned his back on God for Eve. And the whole world, the whole mankind suffered because of Adam loving Eve more than God. Women, don't marry a man that loves you more than he loves God. You headed for destruction. Man, don't marry a woman that will allow you to compromise her and love you more than they love God. Don't do it. Amen. I am thankful to God that I have a man that loves him more than he loves me. Because you know why? I know that he is going to continually lead me in the way of God. He is not going to allow me to stray in the way of God. He's going to tell me, Cheryl, you need to go get on your face and repent. That's not right. I'd be so mad. I'd be saying, you don't tell me what's right. I know how I feel. You don't tell me how I feel. He said, but it's not God. I don't care how you feel. And you need to get on your face and you need to repent. And I'd be sitting there just steaming mad. And I'm going like, I will not repent. I know how I feel. I know I have a right to this feeling. And the Holy Ghost will shake me. And the next thing I know, I'm on my face in my prayer closet asking for forgiveness and repenting because I know that my husband loves me enough to show me the right way. And he is not going to take the fruit. He told me many a time, Cheryl, I'm not on your side. I said, why don't you ever be on my side about things? He said, I'm on God's side. I'm always on God's side. Hear God while he's talking to you tonight. Amen. Being a believer in Jesus Christ, you cannot just be casual with the things that God has instructed us to do. Hallelujah. We cannot disregard, amen, we can't have a disregard for a deep spiritual purpose for marriage. And amen, we can't just throw away that we have a deep spiritual purpose in our marriage. There's a purpose for our marriages, amen? And we can't justify stuff for dissolving what God has joined together. We can't, well, she wasn't this way and she wasn't that way. And man, you know, I got tired of this and I got tired of that. Or girl, you know what? He ain't nothing but a mama's boy. That's all he do. He stick up on his mama and blah, 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 blah. Amen? Ask yourself, whose image or whose nature does your marriage reflect, God or the devil? Come on now. If there's nothing but disaccord, division and discord in your house, your reflection is of the devil. That's not God. God is not a God of division. He is not a God of discord. Amen? Confusion, mayhem, chaos. The devil will exaggerate any part of you or your spouse that is not like God. He'll exaggerate it to the point that your mate can't hardly stand you anymore. Amen? Thinking they all that and then some. Amen? Either side, male or female. Come on. How do we disarm the devil from doing this? How do we keep the devil from showing up the flaws, amen, in our mates, amen? How do we do that? By becoming one in character, commitment, and Christ-likeness. Come on now. You know, this morning I said, as part of Sister T's brother testimony, that the young lady that he is dating said that if you're going to interfere with my life with Christ, my relationship with Christ, we're going to have to cut this loose right now. That's what we need to do right now in any relationship. Young people, You run into some people that you really like at school. You want them to be your friend, but now all of a sudden they trying to lead you into things that you know that you're not supposed to be in. It don't matter whether your mama and your daddy can't see you. God sees you all the time. Don't be tempted. Listen, it's not a sin to be tempted, but it is a sin to indulge in the temptation. You have to turn around. You didn't know them people last year. You didn't know them 2 weeks ago. You didn't even know them yesterday. Now, all of a sudden, they become so important in your life that you'll go against what God has shown you all of your life to be in a relationship with them that's going to lead you down a dangerous road. You don't need to do it. Ladies in this house, amen, don't get so desperate for a relationship that you hook up with something that God didn't give you. No matter what it looks like, how it looks, amen. Both being, amen, by becoming one in character, commitment, and Christ-likeness, and both being holy as God is holy. You want a holy person in your life. You don't want just somebody in your life. You want a holy person in your life. Amen. I'm going to go ahead and try to move through real fast. I'm going to give you some scriptures. Amen. That you can write down. You know them. Amen. Amen. We must be in perfect communion. We must establish a perfect relationship marked by perfect love, perfect trust, and perfect communication. Perfect love, perfect trust, perfect communication. I said this morning, do unto others as you would have them to do unto you. If you don't show, you leave when you get ready and come back when you get ready, so can I. Huh? What you mean, I got to tell you where I'm going, how long I'm going to stay, when I'm going to be back, and I got to be on time on getting back, but you don't tell me nothing about what you're doing. I don't even know when your off day is. How would you know unless they told you? You sitting up here, you know, you may be shaking your head and going, but you know, maybe it's not like that. Maybe you know what, but it's still. Do you get the gist of it? Maybe the ones that's shaking their head and saying, are the ones that's doing it. Why in the world would you expect something out of somebody that you're not giving? Come on now. This is what we're to seek to establish, how we are to seek to live. Amen. This is what God planned for us, what he desires and what God is committed to helping us create. That is a perfect relationship. You say, well, can't nothing be perfect? It can be perfect in God. It can be perfect in God. Amen. It might not be perfect in your flesh, but it can be perfect in God. Amen. Genesis 1, 18 through 24 is where you need to go. And, you know, note it down. This is one thing. Leave and cleave. Parents, let it be okay for your kids to leave. And when they leave location to go cleave with their husband and their wife, let them be there. Don't call them every day. What you doing? Well, do you really want me to tell you what I'm doing? Amen. When you coming over here? Over here? I got my own home. Why I have to show up at your house all the time? Why I got to be at your house on every occasion? Why I got to be at your house on Christmas? Why I got to be at your house on Thanksgiving? Why? Why you got to go on vacation with us? No, you can't go on vacation with us. No. We got one room. No, you can't stay in there with us. Amen. Glory to God. When are you going to make your own traditions? When you going to make your own tradition? When you going to make your own tradition, Sister Tashayla? Let us come to your house. You traveling all over the world. I'm going to be in Sweetwater this and Christmas. No, it's Thanksgiving. No, it's New Year's. No, I don't know. I'm not sure. Let me think about it. Glory to God. I love parties. I love traditions. But you don't have to hang on me. I don't like hanger-oners. I enjoy my time with my husband. I love company. Don't get me wrong. I ain't got to explain nothing to you. You know I love you seeing you. Yeah, come on in. I'm going to be in there looking crazy, and you just come on and go like, oh, Lord. Hey, Co-Pastor, you look nice. Amen. I love time with my husband. Don't you love time with your wife and your children? Oh, you got to have somebody else always there. We're to become and remain one flesh, a lasting relationship, not regretful. Amen. I wish I wouldn't have never married you. Well, that's it there. I done packed my clothes, baby. They was packed last week anyway. I got them. I'm in the car. I'm going. Don't have a car. I got a taxi. I got somebody coming. You ain't got to tell me two or three times. You know, if you don't want this hymn will move on. Amen. Not boring. Amen. Don't be so boring. Boring old people. I've never seen so many boring young people in my whole life. Don't do nothing. Nothing. What y'all gonna do for so-and-so? I'm gonna sit around looking at a football game. Really? For real? Y'all don't do nothing. Okay. Tired out. Amen. I'm just about through, Brother Eddie. Don't get nervous. Ephesians 3:14. Y'all turn over there, amen. Amen. You can note it down if you want to. Turn over there, amen. Family. Marriage is rooted in the name of Jesus Christ. God loves us and loves our marriages. God blesses those who he loves. Amen. He has spiritual and natural riches beyond measure for us in our marriages. God has purpose for our marriages. We need faith to believe in God's love for our marriages. Did you hear me? We need the faith to believe in the love that God has for our marriages. The defining characteristic of a relationship, do you know what it is? Mutual love. I told Pastor, I say, it's so good loving somebody when somebody loves you back. Amen. It's so good loving somebody when somebody loves you back. Yeah, you just beat yourself into the ground, and they still act like you're invisible. Amen? Somebody said, Glory to God. I want to know that you love me back. Don't just tell me you love me. Show me you love me. Act like every day you love me. Amen. He has spiritual and natural riches for us. Amen. The defining characteristic of a relationship is mutual love. John 5:20 and John 14:31. Y'all go over there and read it. Wrote too much. Always happened. You hear what I told y'all, didn't you? All right. Amen. The strongest mutual love is not physical or sexual or emotional, but spiritual. You can't love nobody better than loving them spiritually because you care for them. Did you put it up there, Sister Francis? Amen. Praise the Lord. Look at 1 Corinthians 11:3. Can you put that one up there, Sister Francis, for me right quick? Amen. 1 Corinthians 11:3. But I would have you know that the head of every man is Christ, and the head of the woman is the man, and the head of Christ is God. Amen. That is the order of a family relationship. Keep this line of authority established, and peace has the opportunity to flourish. Break the line, and problems can't help but to emerge. So God has established several key truths from Genesis 1:1. Number one, divine purpose. What was that? To bear fruit and have dominion. Amen. That's Genesis 1:27 and 28. Amen. Number two, two roles, one being. He gave us two roles, R-O-L-E-S, roles. He gave two roles, man, woman, one. Man, woman, one. Amen. And then he gave us a functional relationship. Amen. Females and males are equal. Equal in their command to be fruitful and to have dominion. Amen. These are the key principles that God put in our relationship. Amen. We have different roles and responsibilities at times, but we still remain equal. Amen? Sometimes one or the other has to take the lead to make final decisions. That's taking authority on a work project or on a decision, but not on the other person. You take the lead on a situation, but you don't dominate the other person in the situation. A man has responsibility for and to have authority over his own family, his wife and his family. And this is a function of a husband. I say it is a function of a husband. There is no place in God's word where we can find God saying that men are to dominate women. It is not in the word of God. It's nowhere to be found. We have roles, R-O-L-E-S's, and we have functions, we have authority, and we have leadership, but we do not have domination. The man is not to dominate the wife, and the wife is not to dominate the husband. We're equal. Amen. But there are authoritative roles, right? Who's head of the household? Y'all act like y'all don't know. Who's head of the household? Who's head of the household? Amen. The man is supposed to step up and take the responsibilities of being the leader in the house. And women, as wives, we are supposed to submit to our husbands. Amen. We're supposed to submit. And we're also supposed to counsel, C-O-U, that one, okay, counsel. We're supposed to counsel with our husband when decisions are to be made. Husbands are supposed to counsel with their wives when decisions are supposed to be made. You don't just go make a decision and then come back in and say, I decided this. There's two people in the relationship, and we both have equal opportunity to make decisions. Amen. Now, we might get together and discuss it. The final answer comes from the headship. The husband makes the final call. Even if you don't think it's right, shut up. I was listening to this program one time, and this man was talking about Joyce Meyer. Everybody know about Joyce Meyer, right? And Dave. Joyce and Dave was riding down the street. They were going somewhere. They had been lost for a long time. Joyce was up there in that voice that she had. Well, Dave, why don't you just turn over there, Dave? Dave, you should go down that street over there, Dave. Dave, we passed by this three times, Dave. Dave, why don't you, Dave. And God said, why don't you shut up? That's what she said. God told her, why don't you shut up? And she was taken aback. She was like, what? God just told me to shut up. He said, yes, let him be lost. And so she said, oh, okay. Women, allow your husband to be lost. I've allowed Pastor to be lost a lot of times. He said, Cheryl, did you not see that? Did you see that turn? Why you let me pass that turn? I said, I told you 3 miles back that your turn was going to be at exit 377. You just went right past 377. I know you seen the 370. No, I ain't need all that. You just should have told me that was my turn and blah, blah, blah. So we turn on Holly, the navigator system. Her name is Hallelujah. Because, you know, when we finally get there, we say Hallelujah. No, really. Amen. And so we turn on. So rerouting. And she said so smartatically, rerouting. Then you turn and then she reroutes again. I'm going like, shut up. Turn her off. Amen. Glory to God. Let's look at 1 Corinthians 7:32. Amen. Can you do that one for me, Sister Francis? I love you, Sister Frances, so much. Amen. Glory to God. And this is talking about wives submitting to their husbands. Amen. And if you'll go ahead and read it, you'll see where it says, all of you single women in here, you submit. You don't have to submit to a man. You don't have a man to submit to. Amen. You submit totally to God. What does it read? What's the next one? Is that it? Oh. But he that is married careth for the things that are of the world, how he may please his wife. Amen? There is a difference also between a wife and a virgin. The unmarried woman careth for the things of the Lord, that she may be holy, both in body and in spirit. But she that is married careth for the things of the world, how she may please her husband. One more time. One more, Sister Frances. Ta-na-na. What's the next scripture? It ain't coming. Praise the Lord. Amen. Glory to God. Anyway, it goes on. You can go ahead and read it in your Bible. Amen. But it says that, you know what? The wife submits unto her husband, but the person that is unmarried submits to the Lord. Amen. Totally to the Lord. Amen. Saints of God, as we get ready to close tonight, amen. Leaving and cleaving. Amen. Leave home in your heart and your spirit. All of you people that just got married, get out your parents' house. Period. Point. Paragraph. You should not be living in your parents' house. If you're married, you should not be on your... If let me tell you this much. If he couldn't support you before you got married, you shouldn't have married him. You know, I told you a while ago, I don't need no amen. If he could not support you before you got married, you shouldn't have married him. This is what we're talking about tonight. We get married for all kinds of different reasons, and we don't get married. Because why? We need our marriage to reflect Christ. Amen. You know, you having to move every other month does not reflect Christ. You getting your cars pulled off does not reflect Christ. What it does is reflect of the division in your house, and the devil is in the middle of it. Amen. So if you're getting married, sit down and think about it. That's why we're always encouraging people to get counseling before you get married. And I'm going to tell you straight up, girlfriend, I like stuff. And so, therefore, if that dude can't buy me stuff, he ain't fixing to marry me. I can do bad by myself. Come on now. Or I can just get by myself. I'm not going to even say do bad by myself. I can get by myself. Sister Liz, if he ain't making as much money or more, and he needs to be making more than you, you don't need him. You say, Compass, it's about money, yes. Can I see your resume, please? And your blood work. I need your resume and your blood work, okay? You got a clean bill of health? Because we ain't going, no, this will not be consummated without blood work. Amen. No Hebes, no GBs, and no HIVs. We not going there. We ain't going there. Hallelujah. Y'all don't want to get right. Parents, help your children leave and cleave and to create their own homes. Amen. Listen, saints of God, all of you that are just getting married or thinking about getting married, you already married for a little while, accept the fact that you're married. You are no longer by yourself. Act like it. Act like it's somebody else in the house with you. Oh, Lord. Amen. You need full consent and participation from your spouse always. You need full consent and participation from your spouse always. They need to know where you are, know what you're doing, and they need to like where you are and like what you're doing, or you don't need to be doing it. Saints of God, find something that each one of you like and do it together. Find something. I don't know what I like the pastor will like and do it with me. It don't start with an S. H-O-P-P-I-N-G. That's my favorite thing. Amen. Glory to God. Amen. But I know that there are some things that pastor like to do, amen, that I don't particularly care about doing, but I can enjoy it. I know he likes to watch basketball, and I can talk to him. He tolerates me. When there's nobody but just me and him in the house, he will tolerate me and make me feel like I actually said something smart, you know. But then, yeah. And then Kendrick will come over and just pop my butt. Grandma, you really know you don't care. He does. You don't even know what that means, Grandma. Really? 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 Why are you even trying to talk? I said, well, I'm just trying to be in the conversation. Why? I was like, gee, Kendrick, you don't have to be so mean. I'm not being mean, Grandma. You just don't know what you're talking about. I said, I'm just trying to talk. Nobody else is talking, Grandma. I'm kind of like, really? Gee, okay, well, I'm going to go cook something then. I'm going to go look in the back room or whatever. I'm just going to go somewhere. And then they'll leave. I mean, Kent, my son, is the same way. He is. He don't even tolerate me. Does he tolerate you, Sister T? I know he don't tolerate you. Sister T is like, what happened? Sister T, bless her heart. I just love her some me. I mean, me some her. She said, why that happened? Why they do that? Why they doing that? Kenneth's like, take a nap to Shayla. Y'all know y'all be doing, y'all. Some of the women in here are really sports fans, though, and they know statistics and everything. I don't give a care. I don't give a care. Do you care, Sister Shantae? Do you care, really? You're not a sports person either? Praise Jesus. I was happy when Tori said that she didn't want to play soccer anymore. I said, yes! One diva! All right, then. Okay. All right. We'll take one, Lord. We'll take one. Amen. Glory to God. She said, Papa told me I'm just like Kyra. She said, I'm still not going to play soccer. I said, give me five, girl. Come on. Amen. Bless the Lord. Y'all stand on your feet tonight. Anybody, I pray that you have heard something tonight that has given you a reason to think. Given you a reason to think. Amen. Glory to God. I even, check this out, because I really do love Pastor's company. I really and truly do, especially when we're having fun. He's a really good, fun person to have fun with.
Whether you like it or not, you got to put up with it.
Amen. Are you talking to me? Uh-uh. See how he is? He ain't right. But that's okay.
You.
That's all right. That's all right. I know. I understand. But, I mean, we can have a real good time, amen, unless we're at the gym together. We just don't do that. We go together, but we stay away from one another. He wants you to work too hard. I'm going like, I am not working that hard. I'm on the treadmill talking about. I'm strolling on the treadmill. Looking at TV. Tell me, girl, no, she didn't. What? He over there with these irons. I said, see there? He gonna come to the house and he gonna want me to. He gonna come to the house, he gonna want me to put massage on his muscles and everything. Amen. I see him over there. I'm gonna tell him I saw you. Amen. Over there.
That's what that woman is for.
With them 950 pound
iron. Come rub my body down. You get that aching pain out of me. No.
He over there with his belt on. I'm talking about just barely breaking the sweat. Raise the thing up a little bit. But I did ask him, I said, Kenneth, hey, how about us learning how to play golf? He said, hey, that might be pretty good. I said, I bet we'll like it too. So we're going to learn how to play golf. Amen. On the cool, shady days.
You know, I'm striving to get back in the tap dancing class.
I don't have enough rhythm for that.
I'm striving to get co-pastor.
I don't even have the rhythm for that. I don't have rhythm like.
One of these days, I'm going to do a show for you.
He and Kendrick and Kyra took tap dancing lessons together. Yeah.
Yeah, of course,
Kendrick was one of the best students.
He was the best one.
And they were going to put him on the little dilly whacky dacky dacky dacky.
Yeah.
And Kendrick goes, they tell everything. You know you were sharp on them tap dancing. Clackety, clack, 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 clack. Even Kari, she was talking about. They wasn't little either. They wasn't little kids. They were big.
I still got my shoes.
Kari got hers in the closet too.
I'm going to work.
You know Kendrick got his. He don't sell nothing. He got Nikes from 1998. No, you wasn't born. Did you have Nikes in 98? I bet you did. Glory to God. She go like, he's like, who? How old were you in 92? '98? Four. Praise the Lord. Glory to God. But you know.
Can I say this?
Sure.
You did a great job tonight. Yeah. So did. You know why you did a great job? You didn't talk about me too much. That's good.
I didn't call you out.
That's good.
I didn't call you out.
That's real good.
I didn't have anything to call you out
about. Thank you, Jesus. I'm doing better.
Yeah, that's right. You are.
Didn't throw me under the bus.
Uh-uh. No.
But I want to say to you that has your marriage is not together. You done lost that marriage. You divorced and all that. Don't go back into that marriage. Because the same abuse is there. And if you don't come to the conclusion that that is not going to change, you're going to keep on reaching for the same thing. And one of the reasons why you don't never conclude that the marriage is over and you keep on going back off into tormented situation, being abused, because you live in a state of unforgiveness. And when unforgiveness in your heart, you always want vengeance back, and not vengeance exactly. You go back to the person because you still think they owe you something. Not knowing the person got the same set of mind that you left. Either you go back to that or you're going to get someone like that.
Right.
Don't do that.
That's going to come in and wreck your life up again. Forgiveness must have taken place. What you mean, Pastor? Release it.
Her.
Release her. Release them and let them go. So you can go on with your life. God will never bring something to you until you get what's not God out of your way. Amen. And unforgiveness will keep a person, even though they're present not in you, or your face. Amen. Unforgiveness always keep a person in your spirit, on your mind, in your conversation, and in your thought, and in your sleep. And the first choice you make when you do go get a date is the one that you left that still don't want you.
Because that's all you recognize. That's all you
disrespect
recognize.
Disrespect you. Disrespect the kids. Disrespect you and everything about you. And yet you still want it. Because you're living in a stature of unforgiveness. Amen, amen.
It's not going to change either.
I can't get you off my mind. That's because you still want something from that person. And they ain't going to never recompense you back to the place of love that you want. They going to always recompense a torment, abuse in you. Let that person go and let God have his way. Amen. Oh, rich run, young ruler, you only like one thing, and that's to let go what's possessing your heart. Then you can have what the heavens can give. Hallelujah. It's in the house. It's in the house. Therefore, you'll never cross over to a new relationship because you're still in the old. And the old gonna always give you the same thing that it gave you the last time. Hallelujah. My mother may have divorced, and I'm glad she did, because my dad was taught me like that. She supposed to leave that Negro. Amen. She let him go. I remember when mama packed up her car, and all 12 of us knucklehead looking around the corner. Throwed us all in the back of that and headed to California with us. Left that abusive daddy sitting in that room. She said, I'm not going to put up with this no more. You're not going to keep on abusing me before my children. I'm not putting up with that. And she loaded us up and took us off and started a new life and did better in her old days than she did in her beginnings. But she got the mix of that abuse. I thought I would say this tonight because it's in the house. Amen. And you planning to go back now. What? You crazy. When you go open your eyes that this is not going to last. How many times you got to fall down to the left to get back to the right, to go back to the left, to get back to the right, to go back to the left to find out nothing working for you? When you going to make up in your mind that God got something better for you?
And sometimes you don't get another chance to get out of the relationship. There was a woman from Levelland, Texas that was living in Houston, Littlefield. That man drove all the way from Littlefield to Houston and shot her three times in front of three kids just last week.
Drove right there to our house and walked in the room and killed her right before her grandkids and their kids. You better leave that hateful sucker alone.
Or suckerette.
Amen. Don't get quiet on me now.
Amen. It's true. It's true.
It's in the house.
Amen.
And you need to get totally delivered by asking God to get it out of your heart and let him or her go. The past is over with.
Resist it. When it show up, resist
it's
it.
It's over with.
Just resist it. Resist
it's
it.
It's over with. I'm going to say this, and I got kids by other women, but none of that past, amen, comes into my now. I let nothing of my past put guilt on me. What happened, happened. And I can't bag up and change it, but I sure can change where I'm going, and I'm not going to let you stop me from going forward.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Don't care if you're mad at me. Don't care if you don't want to have nothing to do with me. You can talk my kids again, but I'm still moving on.
There you go, right there.
Don't even care. Praise the Lord, somebody. I'm just passionate about that because it's in the house and stupidity is stupidity. What's insanity?
Doing the same thing, thinking you're going to get a different result.
You're going to get the same result. Because it's the same thing. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If I'm talking to you tonight, you need to get to the altar and say, Lord, please fix me to the place where I can forgive and let go.
Empty me out, Lord. Jesus.
Take it out of my heart that I don't have to live with this no more or be driven back to a place no more. Oh, my God. See, it's in the house. Come on, baby. I know it. It's in here. I know it. I felt it when I was sitting there. Hallelujah. Somebody help God.
Thank you, Lord Jesus, right now. We thank you for your presence.
Move in her life in a mighty way.
Thank you, Lord.
It hurt. It's hurt. It hurt. It's hurt.
Thank you, Lord.
But God going to bring it out of your heart, honey. I charge unforgiveness. You all spirit from hell that has planted such hurt in our heart, that has abused her life, that got her hanging on to something that's dead. Tonight I unroot you by the root, you unforgiveness spirit. I unroot you out of her heart. In Jesus' name. Say this with me, honey. God, I forgive him. And I let him go. I let the abuse go. And forgive me from holding unforgiveness. Today, in Jesus' name, I release it now out of my heart. Go from our heart now. Leave her.
Leave her heart now. Leave her heart.
You foul spirit. Leave her heart. You devil. Get out of her heart. Jesus, place your peace. Place your love. Take hold to our heart, Jesus. Oh, say, Lord, I give you my
heart. All I feel is I see his head coming right in your chest and taking your heart. Woman, you are loose from your pain and loose from the abuse, loose from the remembrance of the voices, loose from the false identity of love, loose from it. You're loose from it in Jesus' name. Now you can go forward. Now you can have peace. Now you can have joy. Now you'll be a woman of virtue. Now. Live, woman. Live from here on out. Live in the blessings of God. Let God bless your life extremely. Oh, God got somebody that got his peace. God got somebody that care all about you.
Thank you, Father God.
And they'll never abuse you. They'll never treat you wrong. You are your children. And they'll never use you. It's over with, Satan. Go back to your hellhole, devil. And I bind you in the chains that you're supposed to be in out of her life. And don't you never show back up anymore in her life. Now, God, give her a new mind and a new heart and a staying spirit to trust you in Jesus' name. It's over with now. It's over with now. It's over with. You'll never be back in that place. You ain't got to be scared of going back to anything abuse because it's over with. It's out of your spirit. It's out of your mind. It's out of your expectation. It's out of your feeling. It's out of your emotion. It's out of your will. It's out. It's over with. Because God told the devil, don't you never come back anymore. You finna raise a standard up because God raising a standard up in your life. And you going to be better than ever. Woo! Be at peace, honey. Be at peace. Abro prekeshe de bakasata. You can be at peace now. You can be at peace now. Yeah, you can be at peace now. Yeah, you can be at peace now. Come hug this lady. I speak shalom into your heart that you may rest from your turmoil. Praise God. Praise the Lord.
Come on and give God some praise in the house. Amen. Praise the Lord. Thank you, Lord, for deliverance tonight.
Thank you,
Hallelujah.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. There's nothing worse than a broken heart.
Oh, God.
In Jesus' name. The word of God said.
I got to. You don't never have to go back to your past. What's fighting over you now is your past. And it's the spirit of hell that keep on trying to fight what God trying to put together. Amen. It's over with. Go forward. Let go. And go ahead and live your life like God has ordained it to be. Feel the Holy
Thank
Ghost.
You, Jesus.
Stop that devil from destroying everything that he get his hands on that God done put together. Hallelujah.
Praise the
Come
Lord.
Come on, clap your hand one more time.
What a powerful night God has delivered to us tonight.
Ooh,
all day, all day, all day.
Thank
Amen.
You, Lord. Thank
Praise
you,
the Lord.
Lord.
The Lord has come
you,
to
Lord.
Bind up the brokenhearted. Amen. Praise
Here's
the Lord.
Here's what God told me, Pastor, as you were preaching, how Satan began to, when a husband's not there, or a wife not there, when the counsel of the Lord going on. He's always keeping a marriage in trouble because he always got one or the other in different places.
Right, right.
so they can't hear the same word.
Right. See?
Because they had Adam and had Eve in a different place than Adam. Therefore, he keep this struggling going on. And you said it good when you said man is the fault. Because man always control a woman. And a woman be so weak to lie to them to do what they do. But I won't talk to all you weak women. Touch to him his garment. Don't be scared to touch his garment. Because virtue come out. And it'll straighten up that man that don't want to do right. Hallelujah. And that's the great testimony that the lady told him. That I'm not going to go no further if you're going to defile my stuff with God. And she stood her ground. And all of a sudden, the brother got saved. Because why? He understood that she's not going to change from who God is. Because you want to rule my life. And somebody needs to stand up in the things of God, whether it's a woman, whether it's a man, and let God put that together. What God put together, let not the man pull it asunder. Woman, stop being weak. Stop giving him an excuse to be where he at. Start living what God is in you, and it'll bring him to God. Let me quit now because I'm fired up about this marriage thing that the devil always destroys. Because he always keeping one or the other indifference. Everybody boshe. Yeah, and that's, I love my brother back there too. I went and shook his hand specially. Yeah, that guy right there standing with Sister Dacia. I admire that. I admire you. I do admire him. And Sister Dacia, the God in you drawed him. He's in here because of the God in you and that baby. He must be a caring man if he's in the house with you. You keep on shining God, because after a while, the God going to shine through him too. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord, somebody. I thank you so much for the message. She said, you need to go sit down. Don't be rushing me.
I didn't say anything. Lift your hand right where you are, everybody in the house tonight. You on streaming, if you're still with us, amen. Lift your hands where you are. Receive the anointing of the Holy Spirit, amen, for the purpose of marriage in your life, in Jesus' name, the God purpose of marriage in your life.
Yes, Father.
God purpose of relationships in your life for the single people in the house and for the teenagers, amen. Let God do the moving in your relationships. Mend the relationships right now in Jesus' name. Close the divisions in the house right now in Jesus' name. Let your life reflect the image of Christ and the nature of Christ and not that of Satan. In Jesus' name, we give him honor, glory, and praise in this house. We thank you, Lord, for it today. And Father God, we thank you that we'll see fruit from this word in immediate days. In Jesus' name, we all said. Amen. Amen. Give God another clap praise this evening. We're going to get ready to receive our offering tonight.
Let me do something right there.
Okay.
Sister
right.
Billy and Sister Shante, come forward. I'm finna show you something that's going to really seal the deal. This your daughter. This is the one Satan fights the most. You hear me? But you got power over this too. You're going to sow a seed for her to never go back in that foul relationship. And it won't happen. I want you to sow a seed in the kingdom of God that's going to stop her from going back. How do you do that, Pastor? Because there's a truth that Abraham himself told his servant, I want you to go get my son a wife. And I don't want a wife from the Philistine country. So he put stuff on a camel, which he was sowing for the wife that his son was going to get.
And when they got there, that camel didn't unload itself until that woman came that he was looking for. And when his son got a wife, he got one not from the Philistine country that was mad and evil. He got a wife that God sent him. Your seed would chase off the enemy that try to keep dragging her back. Come here, Sister Mika and Brother Ledeck, come. Your daughter is growing in the kingdom. Soon to approach marriage life one day. But your seed that's sown for their life will keep them from getting a ghetto person. And God will plant something in their life that's going to help their life, not abuse their life. So sow a seed in the kingdom for your child's marriage. Amen, amen. There you go. You grab your mother hand. Ain't that powerful? That's good. That's totally good. When you sow this seed, you're going to see God do what he says. She'll never go back through that trial again. Never, ever. When you sow this seed, you'll see your daughters in the future have something God sent. And you remember you put it in place. Hallelujah. Gonna set you free. And things gonna be all right. Amen. But I know you can, Mom. Because I did it for my child. For Ken Jr., I did it for my child. I did it for Don, too. Yeah, and it works. The principles of God really, really works. Amen. So get a seed and sow it into the kingdom in the offering that we're about to take up for your child not to go back in an abusive situation. What a scary moment that you have had. Not only that you have the scary moment, but your children has been totally tormented by the moments. And God don't want you there. He wants you to stay where he got you. So you can move on with your life in him.
Amen.
Praise God.
Amen.
Amen. Somebody clap here for the Lord. You ready? You ready to give tonight?
Amen. Praise God.
Do so in Jesus' name.
Glory to God. Father God, we thank you for your word tonight. We thank you, Lord God, as we get ready to sow into your kingdom. Father, we thank you for every person that's sowing tonight. Lord, we ask that you will bless them 100-fold. For those that are on streaming tonight, Lord God, we thank you for supporting the kingdom of God here at Dominion. In Jesus' most holy name, we all said,
amen.
And God does love. Praise the Lord. We want to say good night to our streaming audience tonight. Make sure that if you want to sow a seed in, that you can go to the website, dominionholyghost.org, and give now. Amen. And you can just hit that button, and you can use your debit card or your credit card, and you can give into the kingdom of God. I know that the services are being a blessing to you, so sow into good soil. Amen. Just telling God thank you for providing the word of God over streaming from Dominion like he is doing. Until next week, may the Lord bless you and keep you as our prayers. Shalom. Amen. Praise the Lord. Saints of God, I want to let you know that Tuesday night, of course, we'll be having Bible study.
Saints of God, wasn't that a powerful word that God just delivered in your heart? And me and Pastor want you to know that we care for you, we love you, we can encourage your family to a greater place in life. You can join us if you need our address here in Lubbock, Texas, 7302 Upland Avenue. We encourage you to come to these services. They're better than just looking at it on the streaming. The power of God is moving, and I know I can help you and your family.
Amen. So stay in touch, be blessed, and if you'd like to give us a phone call or leave a prayer request, you can do that at 806-368-0349. And may the Lord bless you is our prayer. Shalom.